Is it better to get a job in a game studio or create your own game and live the luxurious lifestyle all game developers do? Now, we as game developers, we all have that dream to create and publish a game millions of people will play and we see them and all of that stuff that we've been dreaming of since the first day we sat on a computer and played a game. And I also see a lot of people preaching that, oh, become an indie game developer or blah, blah, blah. It's easy, you know, you'll make this much money, that much money. But in reality, things are different. And this is not me bashing anyone's indie dream. That's my dream too. That's everybody, every single game developer's dream is to create his own game, you know, have, you know, tens, thousands, hundreds of thousands, even millions of people play that game. But what I want to emphasize is that a lot of game developers do it the wrong way. They jump in, and this is, I'm talking from experience, by the way. This is what I did, you know. I had the dream, you know, I was full of energy. I learned how to create games. Oh, now I'm going to create the best game ever. I'm going to jump in. I'm, you know, everybody's going to download it, but that doesn't happen. Because creating a video game is so much more than just you typing out some code in a game engine, putting together characters and, you know, and releasing and publishing that. No matter how good your game is, there are other skills that are involved into getting that game out there and, you know, being heard of and getting downloads and all of that stuff. Now, I hear a lot of different people, you know, say, oh, you should do, I don't know, some funding with different sites like Kickstarter, Indiegogo, whatever. Oh, this is, you can, you know, do so much. I mean, yeah, but still you have to get people to hear about your game. We live in a time where, you know, I don't know, you can just Google that and see how many videos are being uploaded on YouTube every single day. That's just YouTube. There's also Facebook, there's also TikTok, there are also, you know, I don't know, Instagram and any other platforms. On TikTok, I don't know, it's like a couple of million, I don't know how many videos per day. How, you know, if you don't have the skills to navigate around, and I'm not saying just organic content, I'm also talking about paid content, because organic content, and for those of you who don't know, organic content is just you, this video is organic content, just, you know, recorded this video, published on YouTube, and you know, you found it somehow. But that depends on the algo. If the algorithm doesn't give you a push, nobody will hear about you. So no matter if you do an Indiegogo, whatever campaign, Patreon, whatnot, you still have to do a lot of work to get people to hear about you, you know? So also, even if you do that campaign, if it's successful, you still need a lot of publicity to get out there. Now, again, I'm not bashing anyone's dream, but I'm saying, you should know what you're getting into. You should know, because I feel like a lot of people who talk about indie game development omit so many things. They don't even talk about, you know, how much it takes. Sometimes you can, you know, work on a game for years and nobody knows about you. And Reddit is full of those people. You know, just the other day I read about some guy who was developing a video game for 5 years and he only got 2.3K wish list in 5 years. That's 2,300 people in 5 years. You know, it goes to show that, you know, you need to put a lot of effort into other things besides, you know, just creating the game. Now, when it comes to getting a job, is that a piece of cake? No, it's not a piece of cake. It's not like, oh, I run my resume, there you go. No, you will have trial and error there. But it's much easier to get a job and work in a game studio with different types of game developers. I don't know, AI game developers, people who create gameplay AI, you know, develop this and that. And you talk with them, you interact with them, you see how a game is being built from the inside. And not only that, but you get experience and you see how the game studio deals with different things. And especially if you're an indie studio, if you work in an indie studio, you will see how people market their game and all of that stuff and how you can use the same techniques to market your own game. So in my opinion, it's better that you first get a job because it's much easier, you know, creating a successful game and publishing it. If you want the game to be any good and have, you know, enough gameplay hours, not just, you know, 1 hour gameplay, you cannot do that below 2, 3, 4 years time. You know? So two is minimum. And even if you work, you know, I don't know, 5 hours per day. But getting a job in a game studio doesn't require you 2 years. You can get a job in, you know, depending on your skill set and depending on, you know, if you know what you're doing, 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, 12 months, but it will take you less than publishing a game. And then you get the experience there, see what people are doing, and then you can do your own thing. But, you know, just getting into indie game development, I think that's a huge mistake. I did it. I just got the downloads, you know, a couple of tens of thousands of dollars, but that's it, you know, because this is not, you know, this is not 2014 when you can just create a stupid Flappy Bird game and, you know, 50 million people will download it. No, that time is over. Sadly, for all of us game developers, I wish it if it wasn't, but it is over, you know, and I thank God that it is, because you have so many templates, you have so many things that people just, you know, take a template, and I'm all for templates, I use them, but I'm not just take a template and just publish it like that, you know, just take it and publish it like that. That's what a lot of people do, you know. So, yeah, it's not as easy as just, you know, create an Indiegogo, Patreon, or a Kickstarter campaign, or we'll get thousands of dollars. No, it doesn't work like that. Try it. I mean, all of those people who talk about it, show us how it is done. Show us, you know, if you are so confident in your skills that you can, you know, every single game that you publish, okay, come on, let's, you know, just create a game, preferably not under, you know, if you have some, you know, games that you created before and people know you, but you're telling people they can do no matter if people don't know them, create a game under some other name, give it some other name who is not known. Create a YouTube channel for him, you know, start from zero, create a campaign, show us how it's done, how we can, you know, successfully publish a game in a year or two and get rich, because we all want to hear that and see that, you know, but that's not the case. They don't show that because they, you know, got lucky, because you will notice one thing which is interesting about game developers. Nobody's going to say, oh, I got, you know, I was at the right place at the right time. Nobody, you know, and a lot of successful games have that. They were at the right place at the right time. If they try to replicate the same thing, it's hard. They cannot do it, you know? Especially if it's not, you know, connected to their previous game or their previous studio and stuff like that. And I'm not, you know, bashing anybody who did that. That's totally fine. But, you know, just it is what it is. Say it how it is. Don't just, you know, oh yeah, it's easy. Everything can be done and all that stuff. So yeah, I have nothing else to say, but, you know, I'm up for being an indie game developer and getting a job. But if you're getting into indie game development, know what you're getting into and what other skills you need besides coding, knowing a game engine, animating, putting it all together and all of that stuff. That's all there is to it. If you have any questions, link is down below. The comments are down below. And I'll see you guys in the next video.